Hey guys, it's Warren here, and today I'm going to show you how you can easily make a convection heat-powered windmill with just a few tools and supplies. Firstly, you'll need to download this template for the fan blades of the windmill. You can get the template for free by clicking on the link on screen or in the description of this video. Next, you'll need to cut a square around the circle on the printed template. Now take a thick piece of card and glue the underside of the circle we cut out. Firmly stick the glued piece of paper onto the piece of card. Then, carefully, using a pair of scissors, cut the circle out. You'll then need to cut along the three lines that point towards the middle of the circle as illustrated, but be careful not to cut all the way down. Only cut up to the dashed score lines. Now, using a cutting mat and a craft knife, gently score along the dashed lines, being careful not to cut all the way through the card. And now, if you like, you can decorate the fan blades of your windmill. Simply flip it upside down and use felt tip pens to decorate it however you want. And we'll now attach the fan blade to its shaft. Firstly, use a drawing pin to make a hole in the centre of the circle. Then, take a kebab stick and make a mark on it to measure it a few centimetres longer than a toilet roll. Again, using a craft knife, carefully cut your kebab stick to size. And make sure that one of the ends of the stick you've cut and you'll be using has the pointy end on. Now, using the pointy end of the stick, poke it through your fan blades through the hole that you initially made with the drawing pin. Secure the stick in place using blue tack both on the top and on the underside of the fan blades. And finally, to finish off this component of the windmill, fold along the score lines you made earlier, alternating both up then down to make the propeller on the windmill. And this is what's going to cause it to spin as the heat rises and passes through it. And now we'll prepare something for the windmill blades to stand on. So take a toilet roll and place it on a piece of card. Draw out a base slightly bigger than the toilet roll, then carefully cut it out using a pair of scissors. Cut out two pieces of card to this same size, then on one of the pieces of card, mark the center point by measuring from each corner of the piece of card. And again, using a drawing pin, carefully poke a hole through this center point, then use the pointy end of your kebab stick to make the hole bigger. Now glue one side of the other piece of card you cut out, and glue the piece of card with the hole on top. And this is what's going to keep the windmill blades stable when they're spinning. Next, take your toilet roll and glue around the rim of one end of the roll all the way around. Stick this end of the toilet roll onto the base we've just made, trying your hardest to make sure that hole we made is in the middle. And next, cut out another piece of card to the same diameter of your toilet roll and again mark a hole in the middle. Use a drawing pin to poke a hole through, and again the pointy end of your kebab stick to make that hole bigger. Now run some more glue along the rim on the top of the toilet roll and glue the piece of card you've just cut on top. Leave all the glue to dry so your windmill structure can stay together. And meanwhile, why not make some more decorations for your windmill? Using a piece of paper that's big enough to wrap around the toilet roll, I'm drawing a house front that's coloured in felt tip pen. Then glue the back of your decoration, and only once the glue has fully dried on the windmill structure, stick the decoration around the toilet roll, fastening into place at the back with sellotape if needed. And then your windmill's complete. Simply slot the fan blades through the hole in the top of the windmill and place on top of a heat source. Always make sure you place the windmill on something heat resistant and never place it on a heat source that can cause danger or a fire risk. And there you have it, that's how easy it is to make this convection heat-powered windmill with just a few tools and supplies. Now, if you loved this video, remember to give it a thumbs up and check out more of my videos by clicking on one of the videos appearing on screen.